डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एमआरआई इमेजेस ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर पेशेंट. ही इज अ 70 ईयर ओल्ड मेल पेशेंट विद फाइंडिंग सजेस्टिव ऑफ वीकनेस एंड पेन इन द शोल्डर. सो विल स्टार्ट विद द कोरोनल इमेजेस एंड दे सजेस्ट दैट देर इज वॉट इज वी कॉल्ड एज अ बाल्ड हेड अपियरेंस ऑन द पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द ह्यूमरल हेड. सो इफ यू सी हियर द टॉप पार्ट द रोटेटर कफ इज डेफिशियंट एंड ऑन द बैक the rotator cuff is deficient. So this is what we called as a bald head appearance from here to here. Here you can see on the anterior part, you can see a good tendinous area. So in this particular case, we can say that subcapularis tendon is particularly intact in this particular patient. Now if you see these images, you can see that there is a minimal acromial overgrowth. So there is a very minimal acromial spur on the anterolateral aspect, and if you go laterally, you can see that there is minimal arthritis. This is the acromioclavicular joint, this is the anterior edge of the acromion. These are the two bony pathologies which can be seen in these patients who have rotator cuff pathologies. Now as we go on to the medial side, we can see that we can start appreciating the rotator cuff tendons, and you can still see a better rotator cuff tendon here than here. So it is predominantly the tear pattern is more on the posterior aspect of the shoulder, and this was also evident by the clinical examination, which showed that the patient has what is called as a hornblower sign. The other thing you must realize is you can see that you have a little bit of fatty degeneration in these two muscles. The subscapularis muscle is a very good, you can see a very good muscle bulk in this area, but there is some sort of a fatty infiltration and some not a very clear signals of muscles in the infraspinatus and the teres minor subgroup along with the supraspinatus. So predominantly this patient has a tear of infraspinatus and teres minor and extending up to the supraspinatus. So if you see here, this is the coracoid, this is the glenoid, which is all normal. This is the spine of the scapula, which you can see, and this is the acromion, which starts from here and goes up to here, and you just need to see the morphology of each and every thing. After doing seeing the coronal images, we will see the sagittal images, and if you focus your attention onto the sagittal images, you can see that you can appreciate the subscapularis muscles nicely in the front of the shoulder, but on the back the infraspinatus and the teres minor are very very weak. You can see striations into them, so they are very weak muscles. You can see just very very small sort of an empty appearance on the posterior aspect of the shoulder. Here you can see very good muscle. Compare this muscle with this muscle, you can see a very good muscle bulk here, and this muscle, you can see here, this muscle is not very good. This is all sort of a muscles with fatty infiltrations in between. So this is sort of a predominantly a posterior superior cuff tear pattern in which you have a deficient posterior superior cuff, and this needs to be addressed the same way. Here also we can see, if you see the tangent sign here, the tangent sign is basically you connect the coracoid with the spine of the scapula, and this is lying below this. So this is sign of what is called as an atrophy of the supraspinatus tendon. This you can see the subscapularis is a very good muscle bulk here, but supraspinatus and infraspinatus are decreased in bulk, and this is suggestive of this kind of a chronic patients who have injuries due to long old standing tears. This is again the sagittal images, again the same thing. You have got a good subscapularis muscle here. The bicep tendon is good. You can see some inflammation in the bicep tendon, but overall the bicep tendon is very nicely visualized in this area. From here the supraspinatus, you can see there is a tear in the supraspinatus, and then whole of the infraspinatus fossa is deficient. The muscle is also deficient, and you can see here that almost this much of the humeral head is exposed posteriorly. So that is a deficient area where there is no muscular tendinous insertion seen on the back of the humerus. And then we come to the axials of this patient. Again you can see the same thing. This is a posterior superior tear pattern, so the subscapularis you can see very nicely. The biceps is also very nicely seen into the groove. There is not much of swelling in the bicipital groove. There are lot of strong muscle fibers which you can see in the subscapularis region. The glenoid is good, the humeral head is good, the humeral head is little bit rotated internally, which is very common because the patient has a good internal rotation force and a poor external rotation. So internal rotated humeral head is a sign of again a posterior superior wear pattern or posterior superior tear. You can see that there is a good subscapularis but a deficient infraspinatus here. So again, this is a pattern which is very classical of a infraspinatus disease minor. You can see that this is the tear of the infraspinatus. The infraspinatus ends here, whereas it has to go up to here. So it is a retracted sort of infraspinatus tendon which we can see in this particular image. So these signs are the, these are the actual images in which we can see. Now these actual images are also good for looking out for the Bankart lesion. If you want to look for the labral lesions, you can see the labral lesions here. If you want to see for the heel sacs, you will see the heel sacs lesion here. So actual MRI will tell you about the glenoid morphology, the morphology of the humeral head and the morphology of the labrum. It will also show about the strength and the consistency of the subscapularis and the infraspinatus muscle belly. Thank you.